What is it with people that always have to try to open your beer with a lighter or some other object to show you how cool they are?
Did you hear about this dude in Germany?
Yeah, that's
idiot.
That's kind of what
dummy.
I have a friend that's really good at it, and I can't do it. And I have pretty long fingers, but they're kind of length, like I don't know if they're skinny, but they're definitely not thick. And
they're definitely not skinny. I'll tell you that right now.
Put your hands up. I bet you my fingers are skinnier than your fingers.
You know, whenever you hit the phone bank, you hit one button and three buttons trigger, okay?
Okay, well, they're not that skinny. But they're not these big, strong man hands. Anyways, and he's got that. He's like, oh, give me that beer. And then he sits there and he hits the
this guy
gets the lighter out and he's like, give me that thing.
This guy
there
in
you go.
Germany.
Back to you.
Tried to open his beer bottle with a pepper spray canister inside of a crowded movie theater. Which is terrible, right? Like, that's like the worst thing you could do inside of a crowded movie theater because, well, what happened? The button popped off the pepper spray and the pepper spray got out all throughout the movie theater and they had to evacuate the movie theater, 200 people in the movie theater because this guy tried to open his beer bottle.
He should have to reimburse
totally
the movie theater for everybody's ticket that went to that theater that day, the idiot.
And work out some kind of concession allowance, like what an average 200 people theater will sell for concessions on a night, that he's got to pay them for that.
And if
too.
You're going to go to the movies or you're going to sneak beer in, you don't bring bottles, okay, you jackass? You bring a can.
Yeah.
You bring cans. Yeah. You don't bring bottles.
It's totally legal, by the way, in Germany to take beer to the movie theater.
So it's okay if you can bring your own beer?
Yeah, you can bring your own. You could take your own. And that's what he did.
We should have him adopt that policy here.
I know. Wouldn't that be nice?
As long as it's not bottles.
I still do it, though. I mean, I do it, and I do bottles, too. But if I'm going to do bottles, I bring a can opener. This is what a bottle opener. This is what I understand about dude that has to open a beer bottle with everything except a bottle opener, okay? Is bottle openers are made very convenient. Every tchotchke company in the world that has, like, tried to...
Right. I have one on my keychain.
Yeah, I have one on my keychain. I have a Firestone.
Most guys I know have one.
I have a Firestone Walker one. Look at that. It's the shape of a regular key. All right? This is not, like, you can't go wrong with this. All right? This, in a pinch, you can open up a beer bottle with this. Very easy. And it takes up the space of a key on my keychain. That's ridiculous.
Mine isn't a key. It was a Sierra Nevada, and it's the kind that fits over half the thing.
That's a good one, too.
It's been a great one. I've had it for almost 10 years.
The Firestone one replaced my Sierra Nevada one. It's very, very easy to have a bottle opener.
I once saw a guy take a Sharpie, and he opened it with a Sharpie. And he's like, yeah, look at that. I'm like, hey, thanks a lot. Give me the beer.
It's annoying because I have a friend, and he's like my best friend. And this is the one annoying thing that he does that like makes me want to not hang out with him is he's really good at opening a beer bottle with anything. He can use a lighter. He can use a weed pipe. He can use a...
the ring on his finger?
The ring on his finger.
I've seen that too, yeah.
So whenever, like, we go to a party with Kyle. You go to a party with Kyle... And he's like sitting there waiting for people to open. He should be sitting on a lifeguard's chair or something. Like he should be
up
sitting
high over everyone.
Yeah, about 8 feet higher than
with a megaphone. Hey, give me that beer. Give me that beer. I'll open it for you.
He's like, oh, you need your beer open? He'll like run across the party. It's slow
throwing
motion.
Elbows.
No,
stiff arms.
Don't open the beer. Slow motion. And he grabs the beer out of the people's hand and he has to open it up. It's like he wants to show everybody that he can open the beer bottle with anything but the one thing that you need to open a beer bottle with, and that is a bottle opener. That's why they make bottle openers, okay?
Yeah, but
they
it's so rogue and cool to use something else.
They made cars so we didn't have to drive a horse and buggy. What? How many horse and buggies do you see anymore?
Why do we use keys to start cars? Why don't we just punch our dashes and just put two wires together? That's way cooler. Hey, Rick, how you doing, man?
Doing good, man.
All right, so what do you open beers with?
So my older brother, God rest his soul, he's not around no more, but he had this front tooth kind of like a Dracula flame
fang.
Yeah, and he could just, pop them loose easy with this little tooth that was growing crooked out of his mouth.
Hey, bro, give me your beer.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You can keep it.
Yeah.
You can keep that.
Yeah, it was definitely classic.
You're kidding me.
All right, thanks.
That is pretty, that is a pretty badass way of opening.
Now we have to
Did he die opening a beer?
No, don't. He's gone.
Oh, he's already left?
That's terrible.
Well, I mean, you never
maybe
know.
Maybe he choked on the cap. Maybe things went bad and he choked on the cap. I remember back when I was a kid, there was a lot of beer caps, but they were twist-offs. Nobody's doing the twist-offs anymore. Why did we go away?
Why did the
twist-offs
go away?
But I remember my uncle used to go, watch this, and he'd stick it right under his forearm and he'd twist it off, or he'd stick it right underneath his chin, under his double chin, and he'd do it right there. He's like, here you go, kid. It was a root beer, but not a beer. Why did we go away from the twist-off? What was wrong with that? It was a bottle cap, and you could just twist it off. And now you got to have some sort of device.
I know. You always got to have a device.
And now people's brothers are using their teeth. That can't be good. I hope you have good dental insurance if you're doing that.
Ugh. Why don't we have the twist-off anymore? Does it compromise the integrity of the beer?
I have no idea. Maybe this is something we call our friend Ollie later and ask him.
Yeah. Is it too early to call Ollie right now?
He's a beer guy. Beer guys aren't. Are they up this early?
I know.
Text him.
There's a reason why we do the Red Zone Challenge Experts Picks in a podcast after the show.
I love how we call Suzanne. We'll call Suzanne at 5:59, and she doesn't start work until 2.
I don't know if I have Ollie's phone number, actually, to be honest with you.
Well, I do somewhere.
Okay, we got to get to the bottom of this.
I have no idea.
Maybe
543-3693.
How come you never see twist offs on? Because all the twist off did was make my friend Kyle look not cool at parties. He would not go to a party if there was twist offs. Like, what kind of beer is going to be there? I'd be like, if you said MGD, he's out.
No, yeah.
MGD, no
twist offs.
No, I can't go to the twist off.
But my game is all about using my lighter to pop bottle caps off.
You know, either that or my wedding ring. And part of the reason why we get frustrated with people that can do this is we can't do it. Like whenever I see Kyle open the beer, I'm like, all right, dude, that's cool. That's cool, bro.
It's like, let me show you how to do it. And you're like, yeah. You can't do it. Like, oh.
All you have to do is go like this. And all you have to do is just go like this. And then you just do this. And then it's almost like he knows that you'll never be able to do it. So he wants to show you how easy it is to him. It's like, you know, if somebody has ever loosened the jar on something, you're like, ugh, I can't open this. Could you open it up for me, bro? Like that kind of thing. It's annoying. It's annoying. These people that feel like they are the Superman of the beer openers.
We got somebody here. Go ahead, man.
About opening the beer bottles, car seat buckle.
Oh
yeah, while in motion.
But because it has it actually has the hole in it, so you can use it as a bottle cap opener.
It's perfect for cracking a bottle.
You just buckle your
seatbelt,
yeah.
But
I want to go open a beer now.
No, I want to go tailgating and go, hey, put your lighter away, douchebag.
That's awesome, dude.
Give me that bottle.
That's a really cool way to open a beer.
Tailgating. Yeah. We're meeting the tailgating. Come on.
Yeah. That is the best way to go about it. Okay, so from now on, that's what I'm going to tell people is when you're at the tailgate and they have to use the lighter or they have to use their wedding ring or they have to use their teeth or they have to use
You're going to piss that guy off. The lighter teeth ring guy is going to be mad.
Give me a beer. Bring it over here. I got a lighter. Let me show everybody I can do it with the lighter. I was saying, why would you use the lighter, you jackass, when you could use the seatbelt?
Go ahead, man.
You know when you... like your front door, when you shut it, where the latch meets the hole of the door.
Yeah.
You can actually stick the bottle in the flat part of the door, and it will open it.
You got to hold the bottle sideways, though, so don't you have spillage?
Well, at first you hold it sideways, but you have to pull it. You pull it sideways and then down. And if you do it just right, it works perfect every time.
Yeah, I got that. Okay. I got that because I actually was watching people do it with seatbelts on YouTube, and it's not as easy as one would think with the seatbelt. That you actually have to use a different part of the seatbelt than what you would normally think.
The seatbelt is more like using a lighter, I would say, you know, to pop it up.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
And then on another one is a car door where the door hits the latch. You can actually wedge the bottle in between the door where it latches, and it's a perfect little pop.
There's bottle openers everywhere on this planet.
Yeah, I think I would. Yeah, but if you don't have a bottle opener, because for some reason,
that's what I'm saying. Everything's a bottle. The world's your opener, depending on how you would look at it. You know,
so you just got to look for things that you could stick a bottle in, and it's got an edge. All right, thank you.
You know, honestly, I feel like I'm the MacGyver of bottle opening.
I know.
I think you're more the MacGruber.
You're like, you love opening other people's beer bottles, don't you? You're like my friend Kyle.
I could do it I can do it with a quarter. I can do it with another mm-hmm. bottle cap mm-hmm. that's not, that hasn't been, you know, that's been off the bottle.
Hey, Kyle, I thought I told you not to call the show, dude.
Thanks.
Bye.
MacGyver, I'm the MacGyver.
MacGruber!
Yeah.
Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.